Hello, my name is Najib El Tecle, and I am a neurosurgeon and spine surgeon at Northwestern Medicine Center for Spine Health. This is the case of a 29-year-old patient who presented with lumbar radiculopathy. An MRI demonstrated a lumbar disc herniation. And here, that's an axial MRI of the patient showing the disc herniation at the L4-5 level. You can appreciate a disc herniation that is pushing on the patient's nerve. For this patient, that's the reason they're having that radicular type pain, a pain that shoots down the leg. And in this case, the pain did not respond to conservative treatment options. For the diagnosis of lumbar disc herniation, as you see in this patient, that diagnosis is amenable to a less invasive option, and that is endoscopic spine surgery. In a way, we're able to get in there, get the disc out, without disrupting the normal tissue around the spine. What you're seeing here is the translaminar approach. We're going down with the endoscope, and now we're docked at the ligamentum flavum. We're using a scissor type device to open the ligamentum flavum, and that will get us into the epidural space. At that stage, you can see the dura there. That's the nerve root, and we're gonna dock on that disc space and start working on pulling the disc out. And here you're gonna see how that disc fragment is coming out of the patient's back. For such a procedure, patients are going home the same day after surgery. In terms of the size of the incision, this incision is as small as we can get to incisionless spine surgery. The size of the incision is about 7 millimeters, and patients often on follow-up, on their 2 weeks follow-up, are not even able to see it. With endoscopic surgery, we're not compromising the level of the treatment. In a way, the patient's still getting the same treatment, but it's just done with a less invasive procedure. At the patient's 6 weeks follow-up appointment, they noted no pain whatsoever in their leg. They were very happy with the outcome of the procedure.